Ladies and gentlemen, attention please. It's a pleasure to present to you a capsule of knowledge with the title, Why the Man Was Created. Before the creation that we are told in the beginning, the earth was empty, messy and lifeless. This could be a great deal of millions of years before man inhabited the earth. We understand that the Earth, the solar system and our immediate universe already existed millions of years before the creation described in Genesis. And the surface of the Earth was all covered with a large layer of ice. Before man inhabited the Earth, bone, before creation, a great rebellion occurred in the kingdom of God. Approximately one-third of the members of the kingdom of God rebelled against God by turning away and opposing Him. This was caused by the desire to be bigger and to show more than they had. It was a misconduct, which was formed in their own free will. God does not have programmed creatures, nor does it force anyone to behave in one way or another. Each one decides how to behave and what their behavior will be. God has beings, who think, who decide what to do and how to behave. After this great rebellion, it is that God decides to make the creation that we know today. God creates and places man in the Garden of Eden in a pure, clean and spiritually full environment of His presence. He puts it without sin, bone, without sinful nature, but if He puts it with free will. That is where He confronts temptations made by those who had already revealed themselves against God in the past. The man disobeyed some ordinances that God had previously given him. Man disobeys God and obeys the one who had revealed himself against God. In that disobedience of man, it is that sin comes to man. Thus man falls from the grace of God and sin begins to reign in man. This is how the forces of evil begin to manifest on earth, including everything in it. God knew this was going to happen, but He also had a solution. The free will of man would be exercised at all times through all subsequent events. God does not alter, at any time, the free will of man. Man continues to exercise His dominion at all times. God begins a plan to redeem man from sin. He begins to educate man and tells him how he should behave so that he can live with Him in His kingdom. Eventually, God becomes a people, with which He will reach and include all the nations of the earth. This begins with Abraham, who promises that his offspring will be as numerous as the stars of the sky and as the sand of the sea. It is then, that with this created people, they will prove the guilt of the enemy of souls. Notice, that the enemy failed before God, being in the presence of Him and surrounded by His glory. That is, impregnated with the presence of God. And perceiving the glory of God. And in counterpart, man, separated from God, and being attacked by the enemy of souls, makes decisions to approach God, to receive Him, and to be filled with His glory. An act, which is totally the opposite, of how the enemy was in the presence of God. Thus, it is demonstrated and confirmed, the guilt of the enemy of souls. The enemy of souls, in a body of high hierarchy and high dominance, departs from God. And man, in a body of little dominion, little less than that of angels, seeks God. That is, the man in a totally contrary condition, manages to get out of the enemy's snares and approaches God. It is so, that God demonstrates, the great guilt of the enemy of souls. Bone, too, this historic human race, is a judgment against the enemy of souls where their guilt is proven. For the people that God has prepared for yes, great awards and functions are reserved in the kingdom of God. And this, being brothers of Jesus and joint heirs with Him. Something big is reserved for those who are brave and seek to serve God in spirit and truth. This is what God has established. I invite you to continue looking for the owner and Lord of the universe, the only true God. This is how, like God and therefore man, they demonstrate the guilt of the enemy of souls. I hope you liked it, this capsule. God bless you. Thanks for your attention. Until next time.